As I told you before, in 1908, I sang The Messenger in Aida. The leading tenor predicted that if I study well and was serious in my work, in 3 years I would be singing Radames. In 3 years I had sung the part of the young Inquisition warrior in the first of the some 350 performances, with my final appearance as Radames taking place in 1948. I tried, when I started, to sing the final B-flat of Celeste Aida as written pianissimo, means very, very soft. But I found it almost impossible to sustain a pianissimo in a sustained high B-flat. I then began to sing it forte, but felt that Verdi would never approve. One day, in 1913, I mentioned my misgivings to Giovanni Zenatello. Giovanni then told me of his experience with the aria. In 1898, he had started to shift from baritone to tenor, and he was called upon to sing an audition for Verdi himself. Determined to impress the 85-year-old composer, Zenatello sang two magnificent B-flat of the Celeste Aida, and then attempted the final one as written, pianissimo. He cracked the voice. Giovanni told me that his heart was broken, for he felt he had failed miserably. Verdi, however, came up to him and told him not to worry. A fine career was to be his, and that he, Verdi, had written a pianissimo, but had never heard a virile tenor sing one, and was resigned to a forte note. For my type of voice, the only way such a B-flat could be sung, other than forte, would be by using the falsetto, which was what Verdi did not want. On this subject, Toscanini told me that Verdi himself suggested to a tenor, after holding the high B-flat forte for half a bar, come down to octave below, where he could finish the phrase pianissimo. The Toscanini's recording of the complete Aida made in 1948 with Riccardo Tocher as Radames contains the phrasing in this manner. Celeste Aida, coming as it does in the beginning of the opera, is very frequently exceedingly difficult for a tenor. It may be interesting for you to know that Francesco Tamagno, the greatest of heroic tenors of the last century, had such a difficulty in the note F with the vowel A, A in English, but A in Italiano, in the word Celeste Aida, that he always sang the aria transposed up to F sharp. The B naturals presented no challenge to him, but the F in the original key is a bridge note of the passage into the higher register, and as such does present vocal problems. And for him this was very noticeable. Today we are astounded at what our fathers and grandfathers accepted. John Dereschi told me that he had sung Celeste Aida only 4 times in the 19 Aidas that he sang at the Metropolitan. It was too difficult an aria to sing before I was properly warm up, he said. He also told me Mrs. Vanderbilt had written a letter to Morris Grau, managing director of the Metropolitan, in 1896, telling him she had heard that Aida had a lovely aria for the tenor in the first act. Costume decreed she must be late in making her entrance at the Metropolitan, so she had never heard this aria. Costume also demanded she leave before the opera was finished, so would Grau on the succeeding Monday, when Aida was to be given again, prevailed upon Mr. Tereschi to sing the solo in the Act 3. So she might hear it. I will leave to you, to your imagination, Graus and Tereschi's reply. Zenatello, too, tried the same experiment, but it did work.